Hello, ladies and gentlemen. We are back with, I believe, the last game of Southeast Asia. We have Bazaar Youth versus Clutch Gamer.
10 seconds gamers. Remaining.
I believe this match. Yeah, this match isn't. 5 seconds. Doesn't amount remaining. To anything. I believe the playoffs have been determined already. So this game is Reserve entirely for time. Fun. Clutch Gamer is securing their spot at 6-2, even if they lose this game. 6-3 record still keeps them in the playoff. So, yeah. This game's kind of whatever, up in the air for them. Maybe they get to try out new things, have some fun. Got a Slard Art Darks here, opening from Bazaar Youth, taking a page out of Clutch Gamer's opening. Big wombo combo potential. And in return, Sand King, Crystal Maiden.
Dire Where did Lumi go? Pick.
I believe Lumi is getting water. I am here on my own. I'm very scared right now and vulnerable. How do people cast on their own? In any case, though, Juggernaut, third pick for Clutch Gamers.
5 seconds remaining.
Pretty damn good carry hero. Paired up with the Crystal Maiden. Unfortunately, since it's against a Darkseer, it really relies on Crystal Maiden's Frostbite timing. But most likely going to see it paired up with a Sardar, so this is going to be a pretty rough lane for Clutch Gamers down here unless they pick another support to pair up with this Crystal Maiden Juggernaut. Assuming this is an offlane Sand King. Oh, hello Lumi. Welcome back. One thing to note is Bazaar Youth ended up banning out Weaver in the first phase. I don't think I've seen this ever.
Is it fun casting by yourself?
Is your mic on? Oh, your mic is on. Is it fun casting by myself? Casting by yourself feels Keeper like...
Because if you're having a lot of fun, I can step out. You're solo cast this game.
You know what solo casting feels like? It feels like you're slowly going insane talking to yourself.
No, it doesn't.
That's what it feels like.
I like the sound of my voice.
I'm not narcissistic.
Actually, I hate the sound of my voice. I think most people dislike the sound of their voice.
5 seconds
what?
Remaining.
Well, is that truly the case?
Yeah, most people hate how they sound on recording.
Oh.
Dire team
yeah, I can agree with that.
Is this the first bat in C?
No. Definitely have seen it before.
No, they today. Like,
oh,
or
today?
In this qualifier.
In this qualifier or today? Because it definitely was played yesterday.
Oh, was it? I didn't cast a game with bat.
There was a game where they... I forgot who was playing... Actually, it was Clutch Gamers. Yeah, it was Clutch Gamers.
So they're bat pickers.
Yeah. They were playing against TNC, and they put bat mid against a Juggernaut.
I don't recall that, but okay.
I don't recall it either. I know what happened. I just don't remember the team. There definitely was a bat versus Jug. That is all I remember.
All right. So I got to ask you, since Clutch Gamer is quote-unquote the new team here, right, like compared to some of the old guards, how would you describe this team? Are they like a single player all-star? Are they well-coordinated? Do they win through drafts? Are they versatile? Like, give me a short summary for Clutch Gamers because we might have some new viewers tuning in that haven't seen this team play yet.
Based off of their two-day performance, I think their greatest strength is their teamwork. They always draft like team fight heavy lineups, and for the most part, they always execute it very well.
Okay.
And although they are, somewhat of an unknown team to most people, myself included, I feel like they play like they have a decent amount of experience. Like, just looking at how they move around the map and make these decisions, it feels like they're playing as if they've been in the competitive scene for quite some time.
I mean, some of these players have been in the competitive
scene. They definitely
have,
yeah. But I know Hana used to play with Scythe, right?
Yeah, we could look it up. Let's see.
Reserve time.
Clutch Gamer. Every one of these guys have their own page. Hana's just Rappy, right?
Oh. Isn't Rappy... Where? What team have they been on? All right.
Armel has played on ACN Arena, a Bing, previously on Brave, and Arcanus.
Oh, I remember. We always used to play Arcanus back in Zephyr. That's where I remember Bing.
And then Rappy has played on Rave and Execration. I'm assuming Rappy is Tana, based on his position.
I guess so. So Clutch Gamer is basically a new Filipino team.
Yeah. Apparently, Boombax has a very long history. Has a lot of remaining. Different teams. Arcanus, MSI, Rave, Execration, Arcanus.
Reserve time.
Alright, he's the previous captain. And then Fly Solo. Also has quite a bit of teams. Rave, Power Gaming, Aceon, Rave. So all of these players might not have played in the same teams, but they have
quite a lot of experience.
Like long history. I think their perhaps the least experienced player is Armel, which is arguably the best player, at least from a mechanic standpoint.
Well, they're doing really good right now.
Yeah. I mean, I think tomorrow will be the true test, right? Like, because we're moving into a best of three. Perhaps they're coming into a format where not a lot of teams expected a lot out of them, so they didn't prepare a lot of them. But seeing how now they have 9 games under the belt, good captains are going to look at the replays and, you know, try to pick them apart.
Yeah, definitely.
So let's see how well they do tomorrow in a best of three. But for now, we're going to play the last remaining best of one. And we're going to see a Magnus.
Interesting. So, you know, wombo combo, I'm telling you. Every game, it's got to be at least one big team fight combo. Going to see a huge RP, Epicenter, Burst Strike.
So, you know, earlier I was on the panel. I don't think you were on it. And I made this statement about Magnus. I feel like Magnus is perhaps one of the most safe hero you could pick up because he just scales into the late game so well. Both in his like team fight capability, obviously with the RP and skewer initiation, but also allows your team to scale well with Empower. The downside is that you have to generally draft your team in a certain way. But I mean, first of all, would you agree with those points? And second of all, what are some possible weaknesses to this hero, do you think?
I think he has some issues with laning.
Okay.
I mean, I definitely don't think he's the most versatile laner. Although, to be fair, you know, watching Ice play in the offlane, it's kind of like...
I mean, that's Ice. Yeah.
But, you know, like, as a mid-matchup, I mean, he's kind of limited in what he can do. He's just pretty much a farmer. But he's not, like, a really fast farmer.
He punishes mistakes in positioning with Skewer, but... Apart from that, he has very low, like, kill threat.
Like, the other issue, too, that he has is, like you said, you know, Empower is... pretty much like his best spell, in my opinion. But
why is that an issue?
No. The issue is just that if you make a mistake with Magnus, then you're done. You know,
right.
You blink in, you miss your RP, you're dead.
Very still skill intensive hero.
Yeah, exactly. You're either a Ryze or you're not.
I mean, S4 has been pretty good on that hero too, from what I've seen.
Yeah, S4 is just good at everything. So
I don't know. Actually, he is good at a lot of things. Swedish people, man. They're just good at shit. You know EGM?
Yeah.
He's like Nintendo champion or something like that.
That's Aki, dude.
Oh, sorry. That's what I meant. Aki, yeah.
Yeah, that's Aki.
And we play Smash together, and he just like shits on us.
Oh, yeah. I watched him play. I mean, he was taking stocks off of Ken at TI.
There you go.
TI4.
Ken as in not Hot Bit Ken, but...
No, not Hot Bit Ken.
Sephiroth Ken.
Liquid Ken.
Is he still on Liquid?
I believe so.
Okay. Alright. WL, give him that punch, man.
Well, Hana's taking a lot of damage.
Ah, it's fine. It's fine. Alright, so talk to me about this lane. A lot of times we talk about how, you know, Keeper of Light is being used more of a shoving hero in the offlane. Is there any reason that he's not doing this right now?
Double Ion Shell in the offlane? Probably because they knew what the matchup would be like up here.
Mm-hmm.
That's my best guess. And simply because of the fact that they know that it's going to be a Batrider and a Sand King together, I think that want to protect their Ursa, because I don't think an Ursa Slaughter is going to be able to beat a Sand King Batrider.
Yeah, I think the Batrider is going to get a lot of farm, even if you're just trading evenly, which is not something you want. And of course, Darkseer should be able to handle the lane fine on its own, although there is quite a bit of kill potential, right? Like, if you could get up to the Darkseer with the spin, Nova and Frostbite, he's just probably dead.
Yeah, that is true, but it's very unlikely to happen.
Yeah.
As long as Darkseer plays it safe, it's really difficult.
All right, so you said that you know, Magnus is somewhat limited in terms of hero matchups and his farming capabilities. How does this lane go? He's actually maxing in power over Shockwave.
I mean, this lane is fine. He's farming, you know? Nothing's actually going to happen. He's just going to continue to farm.
He's actually doubling on CS over
Chiwan. Oh, yeah, definitely.
I mean, look at how you say the name? Chiwan.
No, it's Chuan.
It's like a more Asian Chuan.
Right? I mean, he's definitely going to out. I think he's definitely going to outfarm him simply because of his skill build.
Right. Casually sitting at almost 90 damage.
But unfortunately, when the Flame Guard comes up, he actually has to just run away.
Yep. Ah, he doesn't mind running away too much. No skewer, though. Do you think that's somewhat dangerous against this? Because he could just run at you with Flame Guard. And sometimes you want that eject button, you know?
Yeah, I think he's fine. I don't think he actually needs it. There's, like, realistically speaking, how are you actually going to kill him?
Right? Well, for a mistake, if Armel hangs a little bit too far from his tower, like, maybe the crit wave.
But look at the warding, right?
Yeah.
Like, unless they smoke, there's actually no
I mean, I think Chiron could solo kill him if Armel's not too careful. Or Chuan. I'm just going to call him Chuan.
I don't think there's any way.
Okay. There's no way. I mean, you're the 1v1 master, so I'll take your word for it. Burrow strike happening up top here. This. Okay.
Oh.
Xiang in a lot of trouble.
He is.
This should be a kill.
Dead.
Does he have clap is the question. He doesn't even have clap. Oh. Second crush is going to turn around the man up. Burrow strike's going to come through. I don't think he'll die. In fact, I think it's the Sand King that's dying. A double kill. Xiang manning up. This is the way to play Ursa, dude.
That was godlike. I thought he was dead for sure. Did you see that? He was on the edge when he manned up.
Yeah.
That Firefly was not going to...
I mean, I never doubted him. And I saw I doubted you for his skill build, you know. Max Fury Swipe is the way to go when you're manning up.
Oh, definitely. I'm just actually surprised that the Sand King...
Went for it?
No. He doesn't have a Caustic Finale.
True. Using Sandstorm is actually that necessary in the top lane. In fact, I don't think it's doing anything in the top lane.
I don't think so. What I really want to see is under attack. Some kind of Sandstorm build where you get the Sandstorm DPS at 15. It's 150 damage.
Is that a thing?
I need to go test it. I think it can be.
I wonder if it's a good, like, ancient tactics.
I mean, it's kind of boring if you go for that just to farm.
I mean, it could be a side benefit.
Could be.
Now, the Ancient's probably running around too much.
Alright. Ancient stacking. 3-3 for the Magnus. This is, who is it in China that does this build?
Shade, dude.
Shade.
Or is it September?
September is...
And Shade and the same person. Oh, no. No, yeah, Shade.
Yeah, September is a support player.
It's LG Young, right?
No. CDEC.
CDEC.
Alright. While we're talking about that, bottom lane.
Oh, that micro.
A million damage.
That micro. He's fine. That micro.
That micro. Obbing is a god. I told you, Obbing is a god.
Well, he mangoes an Obbing slash! Okay,
wait.
He's fine. Oh, no. He mans up a Bing! Give him your big bing, dude. And now Frostbite has cooldown. Went in a lot of trouble. His Surge, Frostbite, he's going to run away. Boomback is going to come through.
Clutch gamers.
I mean, I ain't no Grant, but that was Kobe right there. Dude, that was some series of sick plays.
You know why his micro is so good?
Why?
Because he was so sick on Lone Druid.
Ah. Oh.
This is like almost like playing Lone Druid, but you know, instead of a bear, you have a healing ward.
Yeah. Take that. Dude, that was a sick play.
That was impressive. That was super impressive. I'm impressed. I know
Nexon champion's impressed, dude. They did it.
Alright. Well, laning phase is fairly even. All things considered. This Magnus build.
I mean,
it's gonna be treads into Echo Saber at this rate.
Yeah, I say so.
He has so much CS. He's been farming jungle. Okay, you know, I said Magnus doesn't exactly farm the fastest, but if you're in the mid lane and you're building it like this, this is how you...
He's like one of the fastest passive farmer. I think that's the kind of the point you're driving. He's not very good when you're trading a lot of, like, harass back and forth, right?
Yeah. I mean, even then, he's... Look at this. No risk. Just... You were talking about how Chuan could kill him. Oh, he definitely can, actually.
Yeah, he actually can. That's what I'm saying. Sometimes, like, he could have triple Remnant in there, right there.
Really, it's really risky.
I mean, if he's seen the skill build that this Magnus is on, no risk.
That is true, actually. That is the strength of this build. You just never know if he has skewer or not.
Yeah, sure. I mean, you could actually know. You could click on his empower, and then do the math in your head.
Wait, is this says level 4?
Does it actually say it says level 4 to us?
To us. That's true.
It might not say level 4, but you could just do the math, right? Because it scales by percentage. 50% of 79 is not very difficult.
Yeah, I mean, it's like, when you look at it right now, it's easy.
You know what's the next level play to that one? You keep swapping your treads endlessly till the number keeps adjusting. So even the best mathematicians have a little bit of trouble. Top lane. Xiang, gonna back it off.
Yeah, he's fine. Is fine. Oh. Chuan.
Or is that Chuan? Is that how you say it?
Chayun.
Chayun? That's probably closer to whatever I just said. This'll come in handy.
Alright.
Well, you know, like, the laning stage is pretty even apart from Magnus, pulling slightly ahead. But I really think the game is going to come down to what this Ursa is going to do, as most Ursa lineups comes down to. So,
it's kind of important to note that this Batrider almost has Blink Dagger. So, going to have to see what he does with that.
True. I kind of miss the straight Batrider rush Blink, right? Because nowadays, this is like, oh, you go for drums.
Go for drums, right.
I mean, do Batriders still go for drums?
I've seen... the game yesterday, he went for drums.
Okay.
Go, farming the stack. Wonder if he was even worth pulling. When you're against a Batrider, he just like fireflies over the whole wave and takes everything anyway.
Probably not. I feel like one of the reasons that Hannah's so farm is because he's actually benefiting from some of these pulls.
Alright, and he has a Blink Dagger.
Alright. Doesn't have that smoke yet, but you just take the CM to smoke gank with you. Meanwhile, when in a lot of trouble, dodges the Burrow Strike.
They still have Frostbite.
Yeah.
So he's,
wait.
Oh, no, they're just running. He's not getting juke.
Oh, Sandstorm's gonna get used here. Frostbite, they spin to actually break off the Flame Guard.
He's out of mana. Be a little careful. Well, Fly Solo needs to get that Tome of Experience. A little bit behind.
Oh! Oh, there was that! You know, we don't see early level Roshas anymore.
That's
like
true.
Ever by Ursa. Sucks.
The Helm of the Dominator made it so easy for him. He just tanked
a ton
of hits with the Satyr.
I mean, that regen.
I'll take your
well, and the creep.
Yeah. Do you think they Clutch Gamer just kind of got blindsided? Because it's so uncommon to get those early Roche kills?
Well, sort of. I suppose, sort of.
I mean, with the Ursa in the game, I think you should always be aware of that, but there's no wards around it at all.
Yeah, I think they actually were caught by surprise.
Yep, Armel. RP's gonna be there. They Burrow Strike up a Swall. And are they gonna... Yes, they are. They are gonna commit.
Oh, they gave him everything.
Yeah. Well.
You have to be a little careful here.
Xiang thinking about going back in. They do hit the Sun here, and they're gonna go on Hannah. Burrow Strike's gonna actually clip through. And now they're gonna charge forward.
Oh, the Mega Fast Bear.
Yep, that's gonna be a one easy kill. The healing ward not healing nearly enough. And they'll back it off. But honestly, killing Ember there is a pretty big trade here.
I think the issue with Clutch Gamers right now is that their supports are really underleveled. Oh, here we go.
Ooh, nice juke here, getting the spin away.
You gotta be careful, Jung.
Yang is gonna get the clap off, and that's gonna be a kill. Nice skewer away there, and of course taking the Aegis away with the Shockwave. Now we're jumping in with the Ember Spirit.
They do have a stun.
Yeah, Burrow Strike does hit onto Armel, but is gonna get crushed in by the Slaughter. That's gonna be yet another kill. You're right, where's the Crystal Maiden in all of these? She's out of mana, out of... smoke, and that's gonna be yet another kill. They're just getting ran over.
Fuzzy Wuzzy is too much for them to deal with. Ion Shell, Surge, Ursa, Amplify. How do you survive? You don't.
I mean, you try to just kite him with stuns.
You can't kite him, man. You just don't. You're dead.
You
see Ursa running at you, it's over.
If you have a Bing and you could have purged his creep, or purged his Surge, and the Ion Shell, that wouldn't be too bad.
You're gonna see some next level plays if that happens. It's gonna be like he's gonna dominate his own purge creep.
Yeah.
And then Ursa's gonna
dominate
it
and then purge
and
you.
And then he's gonna re-dominate it again. Like he has to re-dominate it at the same moment.
Alright, man.
I mean Obing had some sick micro just now, right?
Sure, sure.
Why would you doubt his ability to,
I don't doubt, man.
To re-dominate.
I just thought that situation, you know, the both players dominating the same time.
Oh, that's a huge stack farm. That's the power of the Empower. You know, Obing and Magnus being able to farm the huge ancient cannon.
Bro Strike
kinda goes down.
Not gonna catch Chiwon. And that's an issue.
Oh.
Or he dead. Maybe Bro Strike for the Slaughter? You could have had it, Burl! No, you can't because you're rooted.
Got him. I guess Sarda was playing it cool.
Yeah.
Standing there.
No, he was staying in the trees.
Oh, vacuum wall. Mid lane. Oh, Fuzzy Wuzzy.
Fuzzy Wuzzy.
Fuzzy Wuzzy.
That's going to be another kill. He's dropping extremely low, but he gets surge.
He has a blink.
He's fine.
See, I'm telling you. You know when teams
have nothing to lose?
Then they have nothing to lose. One, they play better, and two, or you know, on the opposite end of the spectrum, don't care as much.
Yeah.
I mean, is it fair to say that Clutch Gamers isn't playing as well as they could be?
You know, I haven't actually watched a lot of Clutch Gamer games, so I'm not.
I mean, it's really hard to say, honestly.
It's also very latency at the moment, so maybe they know that this game doesn't matter, so their attention is.
You definitely can't rule out the possibility of people just, you know, not really trying as 100, not giving 100%.
Right.
I definitely think they're at least giving, 80%.
I mean, look, you're down 4-10. You know, you're feeling pretty bad. If this was game one of the day where it still mattered, you'd probably like try your best. But maybe, you know, he's like, it's okay if we lose.
Because even if they win this, it's not going to improve their standing, right?
I don't know. Does it? Let me check out.
Because right now they're 6-2.
They could be.
They could be 7-2.
And so is Faceless. But Faceless has a head-to-head, so. They're not going to get first seed no matter what. Okay. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. So what do you think that? Bazaar. I think you have something else. What do you think they're doing very well here? Like, what's allowing them to run over Clutch Gamer?
I think it's just off the back of this Ursa. I think this Ursa is actually doing a lot of work for them. They know how to play around it very well.
Okay. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
They're just making it so easy for him to...
I think a lot of it is also Clutch Gamers perhaps underestimating what this Ursa could do with Surge and Iron Shell.
Yeah.
It feels like when they're taking the fights, they're not bringing enough.
They have a Blink Dagger on Sardar now, too.
Okay. Oh, there's a Centaur just menacingly sitting in the front.
Alright, redominated. Now they have to redominate.
That's a tower, dude. I mean, unfortunately for Bazaar, they don't push that fast, so. I like what Sand King's doing. Sand King's like, you know, forget defending up top. I just need Blink.
I mean, they definitely cannot fight this. He's caught up pretty nicely. You know, Fanting actually was pretty underleveled around 10 minutes. But now he's made it back. Oh, Hana.
He's got Blink, he's fine.
Keeper of Light almost has Scepter too. Wow.
Yep. And Ursa also working towards Scepter, so pretty nice for breaking a lot of these disables.
Alright, Sand King has the Blink Dagger. Man, this is a very old school Sand King build.
The Max Sandstorm build?
Yeah.
I don't think it's that good.
I don't think so too. I feel like if you get Caustic Finale, you can just split push better too.
Yep.
But, you know, I was talking about
the DPS.
The Sandstorm DPS, maybe we'll see it.
I mean, the respawn timer is such a good talent in my opinion.
Oh, definitely.
So, I don't know. But with that said, I've never seen the Sandstorm DPS. I don't exactly know how good it is.
He can buy Blink and then start saving towards that Veil. And then by the time he hits 15, get the Sandstorm DPS. Burrow Strike.
It's only 50 more damage.
Only 50 more.
That's 50%. Alright, maybe next time we play, you pick Sand King and try it out.
Look, think about it. If they stand the Sandstorm for 50 seconds, which is the whole duration.
Yeah.
Think of how much damage that is.
That would be a
lot. You do the math. Who can survive that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, everyone blink back.
Yeah, they blink back if they saw Sand King.
Yep. He is getting purged. There is no redominate.
1v1. Satyr versus Satyr.
Radiant's middle tower is
you know what they should have done? They should have walked up and dominated each other's
They should stand behind the Satyrs and watch them 1v1 each other. It's like fucking Pokemon in Dota 2. Go Satyr, use Purge! It's not very effective.
Alright, they're gonna. Oh,
Skewer. Blink Skewer even got the Slaughter!
Because he blinked into it.
Yeah.
But, oh, here comes the big.
But that's a two man Burrow as well, Epicenter being channel as well, and they are gonna chain stun the Ursa. Well done by CG. Slaughter's in there, and they find him breaking that Blink Dagger down for a little bit. He's amped up, he's slowed down, the Burrow Strike's gonna hit. And your words about this team just echoed in my mind just now. This team is. Great at team fight, great at teamwork, yeah. Good stuff.
Alright, let's see. I think. Yeah, still a slight advantage for Bazaar. Fort Staff is done on Hana now, and Magnus is gonna go for that Shadow Blade. Damn, Magnus is so far. He's got Blink Echo and almost has a Shadow Blade. I think at this point he can pretty much solo kill.
Anybody not named Ursa, I guess? Darkseer maybe he can kill, because Darkseer has
I don't think you can kill Darkseer.
Yeah, a lot of armor.
You can probably catch out a Slardar farming, wait for him to turn on sprint and just kill him. I'm not sure if he can kill Caudle. Caudle's a little tanky, or pretty tanky.
Caudle's got no armor, I think he can kill Caudle.
I mean, I have to remember, like, he's strong, but he's not
blinding
strong
light.
Enough to kill him before blinding, yeah. Unless he's super lucky and hits him again. Alright, it looks like he is not going for the Veil.
I don't think it's happening, man. I think he's just going to take respawn time.
Take the respawn time. Yeah, let's be real. It's not happening.
I want to see, though. I want to see you do it. Spare me the experimentation.
What is a spell that will hold someone in place forever?
Level 25 Ember.
Oh, you're right, huh?
Yeah.
Is that the
plan?
The plan?
Level 25 Ember, and then you sandstorm him.
Oh, they're not going to catch him out.
And now they can actually turn around. Blink RP. That's a lot of heroes. Armel.
They don't have the vision.
Oh, they have a vision
here
now.
We go, though. Oh!
Blinker! Armel! Armin! Go! That's my nickname for him.
Not man mode. I'm pretty sure he would have seen that, right? Like, the ward should have seen them gather up. Oh, well. We'll forgive him for now. I mean, he has made some sick plays, so, you know. Gotta give him some slack.
Dude, I can smell the bacon from outside.
Yeah, I know. Dude, I'm really hungry. What time is it?
Dude, you ate lunch or whatever the meal after me, and you ate like 8 things. How are you still
I'm
hungry?
I'm a growing boy, man. Please, I need to eat.
No, you're called the old man panel. You're not the old growing boy.
Why am I part of the old man panel? I'm still young. Still have hair.
I have hair too. Nahas has hair too. By your definition, he's young.
I'm oh, sorry. I don't have white hair.
That's true.
I'm not gray.
Oh, the centaur stomp. Lasso, that's going to find him. Get him. Omni slash everything.
Everything.
Yeah, he's dead. Nice back wall on top, but there's just no follow-up. I say that, though. Triple remnant. And but the blinding light. That's not the combo, guys. And now Chuan is out of mana. He's on the run. He's going to spend the one-man RP. And look at all of this damage. He's going to get surged out. One more right click. Two more right click. He's going to be fine.
Wait, no.
Wait.
Got out of it.
Armin. Finds the kill. And he might be in a little bit of trouble.
No, he's fine.
He gets mana leaked.
He's
okay. He's
going to get purged.
All right.
Oh, redominate it. Redominate it. Ah, Bing, please.
All right, that was actually some game-losing teamfight coordination. Because who knew what was going to happen if Triple Remnant hit?
It really was. That see, that's what Clutch Gamers would not have done.
Yes.
Oh.
Oh, what? Look at that play. Hannah.
Wait, he's not Force Staff.
Yep. Hannah?
Oh, they.
He's so fast. He's so fast.
Wait. Oh. How does Hanna know? Is Hanna a god?
I mean, he has vision. He actually has vision of Slardar doing that.
Oh, okay, that's right. He's flying.
He's flying vision.
He's flying. For some reason, I thought the Firefly ran out. Oh, Blink RP.
Oh, push him away! Aegis on the ground!
No. He got it. He got it.
But still, good. He's dead. Rip. Surge him away. Oh, that means you dead too. Vacuum? Illuminate's gonna come through. What? That lasso. And now, when? Alright, good push back here from Batrider. And
the, Blink stun.
Burrow Strike only hits one. He tries for two. Blinding Light pushes him back. He's surging. Where's the purge? When? Oh, dude. The Blink Hammer on the back.
That was the shortest Aegis I've ever seen.
Yes. It was milliseconds.
He got it, and then he died instantly.
Imagine if he just pushed him away before the Aegis.
That would have been... Well, yeah, that would have been...
I mean, Darkseid would have gotten it, but...
Would have been cool.
Invisibility.
Alright. Yeah, that's all you got to do for a team like Clutch Gamers.
Yeah.
You know, we knew that they were good. And despite their, you know, somewhat of a weak start, once you flame them a little bit, they just ramped up their game.
So are they the baby faceless, you think?
The baby faceless, huh? I don't know. It's a tough call. I feel like, you know, with some time and practice, I feel like Clutch Gamers can be a real contender in Southeast Asia.
I mean, they already are. They already are.
I'm talking like, you know, faceless level real contender.
Okay.
I'm talking internationally.
All right.
Talking dream come true.
Dream come true, man.
Travel the world.
Has that ever happened for you, dream come true?
No. I have no dreams.
Man, that's just dark, dude. That's just sad. That's some Bible thump right there. All right, here comes Team Bizarre trying to crush some dreams.
I'm telling you, Clutch Gaming is not going to fall for it.
Okay, Blink 2-man crush. Burrow Strike, though, is going to be good. The Vac wall on top. Where's the Triple Remnant in? Okay, Armin! Attack on Titan shit right now, and he's going to work here. The mech's going to come up. Armel dropping pretty low. He's going to go down. Okay, it looks like it's going to be...
Where's the epicenter? It's off in the distance.
Yeah, it's off to the distance, killing a Darkseer.
Right.
I mean, that... Just as we were praising them, they get team wiped.
Did I say they weren't going to fall for it? They fell for it. They got 5-man team wipe.
Baby faceless, guys. Got ripped.
You know what the issue is? It's because they got caught out in daytime. That's the biggest issue.
No, the issue is Armel blinked into double Echo Saber hit a creep wave, and then they got initiated on.
But, I mean, they still had the potential to turn it around, but...
Yeah.
you if you try to fight them in the daytime, did you see what happened? He three-man RPs. They even, you know, had Firefly on top of it, but there's just not enough damage because a full Illuminate comes through and they pop the mech, everyone's just full health again.
Yep. It was also how the order of spells that came, the Burrow Strike happened before the RP. If it was the other way around, I think like you RP, you Burrow Strike, and you Epi, right? They probably win that fight.
I think it would have to be Epi into Burrow Strike after the RP. But still, it's kind of hard to say, like... Oh, they get caught out.
Coddle. Did he drop gem?
Yes.
Okay. That's a big pick.
Well, one way and then back the other way. You know, they got team wipe, but this is a really good start to make it even again. Getting the gem is pretty big.
Well, I really think that Team Bizarre needs to like continuously win these fights in a lopsided fashion because they don't have scaling the same way that Clutch Gamer does. Right? Jug with Empower, Magnus with Empower. What is the scaling here from Dire? Like they got Amp Damage and an Ursa, but Ursa is going to get kited eventually.
Well, he is going for the Abyssal Blade.
Okay.
So with the Abyssal Blade and Amp Damage, anyone he targets is pretty much going to be dead. But I definitely agree with you. They have to win these team fights in a convincing manner.
Yep.
And the other thing too is that I think that this daytime Coddle is really important to them too. So their timings are somewhat limited, and it's about to turn nighttime. Oh wait, I can't do math. Sorry, I have 2 more minutes. No, wait, it is nighttime.
No, you were right.
4 minutes. Yeah, I can't do math.
Believe in your math skills. You are Asian.
No, it is nighttime, and. Once again, I think that Clutch Gamers are going to have the advantage when it comes to these team fights. Not having that daytime vision from Coddle and not having that Illuminate heal is a big deal.
Yeah, you get the bat vision. The Batman. Here we go. Fly solo. Just charges in.
Oh, they have vision.
Yep, and they do see the Ursa, but Ursa pops it off immediately. They Burrow Strike, and it's going to be a clap coming through. Where's the RP? Oh, the blinding light actually puts this crystal maiden away. Oh, there's the RP, nice, and they are just gonna wreck them. Two dead immediately, Armel, and now nice blink into a Yule Scepter. They find Yang, and Yang can actually make the go. Back it up, boys.
Oh, Armel.
It's a really bad sign for your Ursa when the Batrider does not care about your lasso breaking with the axe. Because they will just overwhelm you with stun number 3, 4, 5.
That was really well executed.
Yep.
They knew exactly what was going to happen. They lassoed him, forced him to immediately ulti, and then they just chain stunned him.
Oh, Coddle dead. Died. That's their best defense, and now we're up in the high ground. I can see why Clutch Gamer is sitting at number 2 currently. They're just good.
Told you.
You told me, man. Why didn't I listen to you?
I told you. I don't know. Why don't you listen to me? I'm the only one with 100% prediction rate.
That's true.
And it's only going to go higher. Oh, wait, it can't go higher.
That's not how you math.
Because it's still at 100%.
Yeah. It cannot go any higher. Well, you should retire now as a prediction.
No. It's going to go higher. Not in percentage-wise, but, you know, off of...
In count-wise.
Yeah.
Because 14 out of 14 is a stronger 100% than 1 out of 1.
Yes, that is correct. Thank you for that. Yeah. Math checks out.
I gotta explain it for the kids at home, you know. Because they never done math. Especially not this intense percentage math that we're talking about.
You know, the thing about Bazaar's draft is, like, they have the combo.
You know,
hold on.
The way that you keep pronouncing their team name, I just think Brazzer. I don't know why. How do you pronounce Brazzer? You should Google that.
You're talking about their name, right?
Yeah. Isn't it Bazaar?
It should be Bazaar.
Bazaar.
It's a marketplace, you know?
No, the market says the Bazaar. Google translate that shit. It's very important.
Their name, right? I'm spelling this correct, right? It's like
Google translate, yeah.
Yeah.
It has that lady pronouncing it. You can't listen to it. Yeah, Bazaar. See?
Oh, you're right.
Yeah. The way you're saying it sounds like that porn website that
Dude,
I never
that
visit.
Has an R in the front. It's
yeah.
Razor.
But it's the same Okay, enunciation on the symbol. Yeah. It's distracting me, dude.
It's okay. You know what Franz told me about English pronunciation?
Yeah.
He said that if you ever hear someone mispronounce a word, you should never make fun of them for it, because it most likely means that they learned how to pronounce
Radiant's
it off of reading.
Is under attack.
Okay.
Which means they are at least reading.
Sure. I'm not making fun of you.
No, I know you're not.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, you know, just in case.
Okay. Thanks for that. I won't be a bully anymore, I guess.
You're welcome.
Yeah. These life lessons with Ailson.
Yeah, I'm here all week.
Life lessons with the next on champ, man. You should make that a column.
Actually, wait, I'm not here all week. I'm here all qualifiers.
Yeah.
I shouldn't say here all week.
The qualifier is only happening for 3 more days.
Wait, it's 3 more days?
Yeah, 2 more for the playoffs, and then China's 1 day lag behind, right?
Dude, I don't know the schedule.
Dude, you should be happy. You're getting paid per day. Less than minimum wage, like pennies.
What?
I thought that's what you said.
I was not informed.
Yeah?
They said there would be candy, so I came.
Oh, I see.
BTS strikes again. Just kidding. Don't fire me.
Yeah.
All right.
Sorry, you were talking about Team Bizarre's combo before I like cut you off. They were not using the combo that much?
Yeah, I mean, how often have you seen a vacuum crush? How often have you seen a vacuum earthquake? Oh wait, earth shock.
Vacuum earthquake. That sounds like a sick combo, dude. I think the danger they have is they're like, if you have to go for the blink vacuum play, you committed to Darkseer. And if you don't get enough, that's some dangerous shit, you know?
But, I mean, the other team doesn't have any BKBs apart from
I mean,
the
they
Magnus.
Have a Bing, dude. A Bing could spin that. Right?
Sure.
And if you don't get a Bing, you're... I don't know.
You get the Ding-a-ling. Sorry. You're just waiting for someone to farm down here.
That ain't happening.
Really isn't. Clutch Gaming, but drawing a gigantic circle around the Roshan pit.
Oh, the Roshan just respawned. Nobody's checking it. Somebody leave a wolf inside. Check it out.
I believe in Fly Solo. He is going to
Nova.
Nova,
yep.
Look at that.
See?
A true captain.
I mean, just because he's blue doesn't mean he's the captain.
A true hero.
I'll take that as tribute.
Thank you, Crystal Maiden.
By the way, guys, it's pretty late for us. We had this is the tail end of a very long day. So if my co-caster sounds like an idiot, he sounds like that all the time, but more so now.
Yeah, I'm not gonna argue with that.
But we thank you for your patience, and you know, we know that you guys enjoy watching Sea Dota, because if you don't, why would you be watching this game? I mean. But hopefully you guys could cut us some slack.
Why would they cut us slack? Even you said so yourself. This is godlike casting.
I did say that.
I have to agree. This is godlike.
Yeah. All right, we're going to see Clutch Gamer actually taking Roche for the first time, initiating and finishing it. And I just don't think the team with the Ursa conceding Roche, especially the third Roche, is
a good sign at
all.
Yeah,
it's a terrible sign, rather.
This Ursa has not moved from bottom lane. He's been sitting here forever.
He's preparing his Earthquake. He just can't find the right target.
He's just waiting here.
Oh!
This is it. Got him.
He's waiting for the burrow.
The trap has been set.
Where's the bash?
The trap has been set.
For who? The trap has been set for who?
For the Ursa.
Yeah. Dude, that was super unlucky. He didn't get bash.
That is true.
He got like 2 hits off and he didn't get bash, and then the burrow strike came through. Feels bad.
I mean, I think the sadder thing is that he waited down there for like 3 minutes.
That's true too. You know, that's net worth that he's never gonna find
like
again.
That's like
Give me a real life analogy. Paint it for me.
All right, this is like getting one of those cupcakes.
Okay.
You waited forever to get one of those cupcakes, and you're about to eat it. So you take off the wrapping, and right as you take off the wrapping, you drop it on the floor.
Dude, that is a truly feels bad moment.
That is what that was like.
Yeah, I could see that. I feel for him, man.
I do too. I just made myself really sad because the reason why I made that comparison is because
has that happened before?
It happened to me. Before.
Oh man, dude, that's rough.
I know. But life isn't meant to be easy.
Life isn't fair, man. Fucking life lessons with Ailsa.
All right, here we go. They got the Aegis on Juggernaut. They have everything that they need.
Yep.
Ooh, Armel.
Armel's a playmaker. I believe in him. He's got a he's working towards a Bloodthorn as well.
He has to be careful though. I think you actually do have to wait for the Dire team to initiate.
Do you?
Wait, he's just going in. Hana?
BKB activated.
Here we
and
go.
Yeah, they got they his got yeah, they got the linkage. And then they're gonna just right click him.
And then here comes RP.
Yeah, it only grabs one, but it don't matter. They're gonna right click. Yep. They get the kill. Ursa on the back line though. He gets Jules up. And now the Epicenter's on top. The Burrow Strike is there. Ursa, the fuzzy wuzzy, is just dead.
Wait, where's Aping? Oh, there he is.
Aping is where he needs to be on top of them towers.
I mean, this is just like, you know, great strategy from CG. They learned their lesson from the one time they got team wiped bottom. They never take the team fights during the daytime, and it's just that much easier for them.
Yep. And the other difference is that every single team fight, they're on the initiation apart from the one that they got wrecked in. I think that's also a big part, right? You have a team with Magnus, you have a team with Batrider and Sanking, you should be trying to initiate every single time.
Yeah. Well, that was a pretty simple conclusion to this game. Bazaar. Put up a pretty good fight, in my opinion. But unfortunately, their coordination is just not quite there.
Yep. So, we've seen all four teams. Who do you think is taking the second slot?
Clutch Gamers.
Clutch Gamers?
I'm on the Clutch Gamers train.
Okay.
I think they're the most consistent right now outside of Faceless. And, you can't even just rule out the possibility of them beating Team Faceless.
Wait, we have three teams at 7-2. That's crazy. Like, just think about that for a second.
I know.
How tight this group is. And then you have Mineski at 6-3. Now, I think the seeding is going to stay as it were because we got,
the
head-to-head tiebreakers.
Yeah.
But anyways, guys, we are done for today. It's been a long series of casts. We were kind of delirious toward the end, but I hope you guys enjoyed it. You can follow my co-caster at Ailsen Dota. He is a Nexon champion, a wealth of knowledge that you could get from his Twitter.
Yeah, that's me.
And, of course, myself at Luminous Inverse. Again, I hope you guys enjoy the cast. We will be back tomorrow with the C qualifier playoffs. Should be extremely exciting. Of course, there is more Dota coming your way. EU, CIS, and I do believe North America and South America should be happening relatively soon. So, yeah, just check those out. BTS is the place to go. I guess you guys already know that. But we will be done for tonight. Thank you guys for tuning in. We will hopefully see you tomorrow.
E-Gaming Bets.